the nation's capital and the perfect place to talk about an issue key to national development. Now, for several years, there has been a discussion on measuring productivity. How, where, and when can it be done? Should it be private sector alone or public driven? A pioneer in this area, Chris DeCary, says the more important issue is why it must be done.
We don't measure things, and therefore we are not as organized in achieving the results that we want. From a competitive point of view, if you don't achieve the results that you want in a cost-effective way, there are other people around the world who are going to do it better than us, and they're going to take our business away. And then as our business drops, our rates drop, less people come to the island, and at the end of the day, we won't have enough money to pay for imports, so taxes have to go up. And of course, we're seeing some of that at the moment with the world recession and other things that are happening.
Olivia Smith, the senior economist with the National Productivity Council, says measurement is a fundamental aspect of any company's operations as it determines how productive a company really is.
So you may measure things like attendance, punctuality, throughput of work, efficiency, use of resources, and for private sector companies, they also measure things like profitability. But of course, for the public sector, we're measuring things like outcomes. But it is a shortcoming of several of the companies in Barbados. There is insufficient measurement going on.
Ms. Smith says productivity measurement is key to companies maintaining their competitive edge. She explains that when you're talking about increased revenues for the country or increased opportunities for export, it means an organization that is lean, nimble, efficient, and responsive.
And for an organization to achieve all of those things, we must have productivity tools at work. You know, we're not talking about anything scientific. Very often, it is hands-on management of day-to-day processes. So for example, within the public sector, we're looking at the clearance of barrels, or we're talking about increasing revenue from revenue-generating agencies. It is as simple as implementing a process re-engineering strategy. What does my customer experience? Are they experiencing long delays, long lines? What can we do as management to increase the efficiency in our office to ensure that we reduce those delays and we in turn increase revenue into the public sector department?
Now, from a union standpoint, the former Deputy General Secretary of the Barbados Workers Union, Robert Bobby Morris, says the worker in a competitive era has to be more innovative and recognize his value to the business.
I'm talking about the individual who brings to his work a sense that he's making a contribution, that his engagement, his involvement, his participation in the workplace can make a huge difference in terms of the competitiveness levels of that workplace. That has to deal with China, Chinese workers, Japanese workers, American workers, all of them that have accumulated capital that we don't have, equipment that we don't have, and several other things. And therefore, the most important thing we have has to be our brain power, our human resources. That is the major thing that has to drive our productivity.
The Barbados Light and Power is one company that measures productivity. Its senior team meets annually to determine its goals and what its key performance indicators are. Julika Williams, a human resources advisor, says these indicators relate to the corporate, departmental, and individual levels.
At the individual level, personal performance is measured via one or two performance management tools, which not only measures performance, but there's also a personal development component within the tool that helps us to support employees' professional development as well. At the departmental level, there are those key performance indicators or key performance measures. So an example of a key performance measure would be effective fuel use.
And management agrees that using productivity measurement has been good for the company.
It helps to keep us focused on the goal at hand. In terms of alignment, it keeps us all as employees working towards a common goal. Then there's obviously the opportunity for sharing in the company's success, because as the company is more successful, then we as employees, we benefit from that via reward schemes. So for example, our incentive payment schemes are directly linked to our personal, departmental, and corporate performance.
Productivity, clearly a key element needed for sharpening Barbados's competitive edge and moving us from good to great. For another look at the program, please visit our website, at www.centralbank.org.bb. Or you can follow us on Facebook for additional information. And join us next week for another program in the current series.